Hi guys, and welcome to another guide after doing my long but hopefully entertaining Bakasura episode. As you can see, obviously it's another jungling guide, but with Kali, and this is after the Thor patch. So obviously the jungle's changed, and the price of Hand of Gods is now 700. So I start out with my number two, which is Bloodlash. Does high damage, very high damage. You want to max that first. And obviously, same as usual, you start out at the mana buff, which is located where it usually is, which is here. Where the speed buff used to be, that is where the health buff now is, and obviously vice versa, the speed buff is now where the health used to be. And the defense buff is where the reduced cooldown buff used to be, and now the reduced cooldown buff is where the defense buff used to be, and then the damage buff is the exact same. So my route is usually start out mana, move my way up to health, then over to defense, cross the lane to damage, but as I'm going across, trying to pick up those easy ganks on, you know, the enemies in that lane, getting my attack buff and then picking up the remaining reduced cooldown and speed buff. Sometimes it doesn't work out exactly how you want it to, but I like the new jungle route. It's a bit more challenging than the last one, but it still works fine. So yeah, after picking up mana, this is where I head up to health. A lot of the times you will intercept an enemy, like on Arachne. I'm always picking up ganks, just trying to get the health buff, which is funny. So, after Bloodlash, you want to get her number one spell. I can't remember what it's quite called, but you'll see in a minute when I level. Her number one gives her increased movement speed, and I think it's increased damage. Obviously, if you're low on health, I chose to get Scythe and Blood, but really you should get a number one. So in your instance, get number one. If you feel you can't take it, get number three. But number three, you want to rank up last. Because like I said, her number one gives her a speed boost and damage boost. Number two just hits really hard. And her ultimate's good, but it's not very powerful. There we go, Kali Rage. So there you go, look. There's two people here. Looks like easy kills to pick up. There's one. Put some damage into Thor. Can't finish him off though. Managed to get to his tower. But all junglers are very similar, really, aren't they? I mean, you pick up your buffs, you look at your lanes for ganks, look for calls, you know, and pick up the ganks, and just, you pretty much are trying to get ahead of everybody else from ganking and picking up buffs, you know, and farming pretty much. You're just getting ahead of everybody, so you're unkillable. I mean, in this game, I mean, I'm going to try and make this guide short. I'm just going to tell you what buffs I get, which I've done, what I rank up first, I've done, and what kind of items I build this character on. In this game, I got like 19 and 0. I mean, I don't die. I'm pretty much unkillable in this entire game. I mean, Kali is so strong. People underestimate her as a jungler. I mean, they think, oh, Arachne, Bakasura is so much better. But I really do think Kali is amazing. Some ways better than Bakasura. So, my build, as in item-wise, is usually boots. Then I get Frostbound Hammer. Then I get Kin's Blades, I think they're called. Usually, Obviously, it's a situational item, but Titan's Bane, if your opponent seemed to be getting a bit of physical protection, obviously, obviously you want to be stopping them from sponging all your damage with Titan's Bane, and that defeats you as a jungler. If you can't gank anybody, then, you know, what's the point in jungling in the first place? So, obviously, Titan's Bane situational, but again, I build Kali on a lot of attack speed items. Obviously, getting Frostbound Hammer second is a no-brainer, because to gank somebody, you need to stop them from getting anywhere, and Frostbound Hammer drastically slows their movement speed. So, it really helps being able to stop them from moving so you can gank them more efficiently. So, like I said, this is a short guide. Obviously, I'm going to leave the gameplay going so you can figure out stuff for yourself. You can see how I build. You can see how I move throughout the map. You know, you can see what I do in the game. You know, I find guides this way better because, yeah, people can show you pictures. They can show you a picture of each spell. But it's like, I'm not going to insert your intelligence. If you want to know a guide for the character, you clearly know what the spells are. You don't need me to show you a picture in the middle of the screen what it is. I don't need to show you the locations of the buff camps. I explain them to you. You know, so I find showing you an entire game much more of a learning experience for you, because you can see what I do as Kali throughout an entire game. You know, you can see early game, what I do, you can see mid game, and then you can see late game. And it gives you a better, you know, view of how to play Kali, rather than just giving you a 2 minute brief look at each thing, and then fuck off, go and do it yourself. So, I'm going to leave this going now. I'm going to play some music in the background for you to listen to again, and I hope you enjoy this guide. And I'm sorry it took so long. I've actually got an Arachne guide to make now. I mean, the gameplay's already done. I just need to, you know, edit it and stuff. And that'll be uploaded soon. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you comment, subscribe, like the video. And as I said, enjoy. Thank you.
We chase the morning sun until our paradise is shown, so we can live forever young. Follow the echoes of your soul to the edge of our beyond. But no matter where you go, let's be sure to make it on the last train to paradise. We'll be right back.
chemical, biological, and nuclear weapons.